One of the most challenging parts of business is your dependency on people to move the goal forward. And it's something that you just can't get around because it's a people business, all about people. And sometimes your needs don't meet at the needs of the person that you're dealing with, whether it be a customer, whether it be an employee, whether it be a vendor, no matter who it is. And I haven't figured this out. Let me be clear. I have not figured this out. Matter of fact, I'm far from figuring it out. Creating the fluidness of being able to manage the moving parts. Because sometimes, like even this week, I had different things. I needed communication back from people that I was working with or dealing with. I need to hear communication for me to make that next step. There was a dependency that I had to wait for that person. So I'm learning on how to kind of like, how do I de-risk that dependency? And like I said, I haven't figured that out yet, but sometimes is you have to have multiple paths to move in. Like if this doesn't happen, do this. If this is like contingency plans on contingency plans on contingency plans. Because if you have that one single point of failure, and I think that's what this is coming down to, is like, let's call a person a node in the network of people that you're dealing with. If that node goes down, or if that node is not responding at the speed that you need it to, you have to wait for that response to come back, because you have other nodes that you're managing as well to make sure everything is moving in the right direction. So managing that is difficult. It's a challenge. Like I'm dealing with that right now. It's funny how vision works, because usually when you have a vision, you see the end first. So you like the vision, like you have this vision for something that you want to do, and you usually see the end. But what happens is once you come down from the mountain of your vision and really have to go out and execute on that vision, one thing your planning process doesn't account for is human error. First, starting with your own human error, and then the human error of the people that you need to work with, collaborate with, in order to bring that vision into fruition. And it's definitely a work in progress. It's a work in progress, because it's who you, I always say this, but it's who you're becoming in the process as the vision is materializing. And it's really difficult to account for the human error that occurs when you're doing it. You just don't know until you know, and you get, you're out in the market or in the field, and you're just bumping your head and tripping over your words until it refines. And then you get crystal clear on this clarity. And I think that's, let's talk about that. We're going to talk more about that. It's really like, it's an opportunity for you to build your clarity, because that's where, the power really comes to make better decisions and judgment and things of that nature. I can totally see the use case for AI and automation, because it eliminates some of that human error when it comes to tasks. And, and it's going to increase the speed of getting things to market. So I definitely see the use case. What about you? Let me know. Mental hacks that I have to really practice as I'm going through this journey. And when people or circumstances let you down, like, so how do you deal with that? You take advantage of it. You use it as almost like source power. It becomes a power, a superpower to you when it doesn't go the way you planned it. So what I do is, it's almost like you have to have like this game theory. You got to play game theory. So if we were talking about that node, if you have one node, you have to think to yourself, how many different contingencies behind that. So that way, when one node goes down, you're ready for the next thing. If that node goes down, you already have that thing. So it's really about that contingency planning and building that muscle. This is not something that comes natural. You're not just gonna, because what happens is when you, this is the trick of your mind will send dopamine rush when you actually like establish maybe a relationship with someone and you're in this euphoria and you're in so much of the euphoria, you don't think that this particular thing is gonna let you down. Like you're in the honeymoon phase. So immediately your mind is hijacked by that euphoria. So in order to kind of like kill that euphoria, the quicker you can get to, okay, if this doesn't work, what's the next step? If this, and then really kind of build out that plan. That's the only way to build that muscle and to get that speed of getting to the next thing. And that's leadership. That's just a leadership, because ultimately you have people depending on you and you only can control what you do.
The truth of the matter is, like I just said, you can only control you. So if you made it this far in the video, really appreciate you. Do not take it lightly. With that said, I'm out. Peace.